Hare Krishna. The desire that the dark be darker defines a dark mind. When we hear something bad about someone and we know that that person has already some defects, some limitations, we have had some negative interactions with them, then when we hear something bad about them and we start desiring that that bad thing about them which we have heard be true, then that desire that the dark be darker, that defines that our own mind as being dark. Now, yes, we want to see things as they are, but we don't have to imagine or believe the worst about people. We have to look for the positive in everyone. In the Bhagavad-Gita 16th chapter, in the second verse, Krishna talks about the qualities of the godly people. And one of the qualities is apaishunam. Krishna says, abhayam sattva samshuddhir jnana yoga vyavasthiti danam damascha yagyascha svadhyayastapa arjavam ahimsa satyam akrodas tyagah shantir apaishunam daya bhuteshva loluptvam mardavam rira chapalam. So apaishunam, he says in 16.2, that the godly people are averse to fault finding. That means that even if somebody has negative, first of all, they don't go out looking for the negative. And even if they hear something negative about someone, they don't immediately believe it. They give that person the benefit of doubt. They let that person give the necessary clarification. And just as in a court of law, a person is considered to be innocent unless they're proven guilty. But some people, we presume that they're guilty unless they're proven innocent. And when we have that attitude towards someone, that indicates that our mind is dark. And we need to overcome this negative, critical, judgmental tendency. If we want to move towards godliness and we want to move towards God. So people may have their faults, but desiring that they have more faults and desiring that the negative things that we have heard about them is true indicate that there is a fault within us. And when we learn to give people benefit of doubt, we'll find that our relationships with them will become less strained. And more importantly, we will be able to be more God conscious when we deal with them. Because we will see that they are also parts of God, even if they are temporarily covered with conditionings. And according to their level, our level, we may be able to find some way to connect them with God so that their inner darkness will decrease and their inner light, the light of their spirituality, that will shine through. So if you want to keep a good relationship with them, if you want to benefit them, and if you want to maintain our God consciousness, let's look for the bright side in others, not the dark side. Thank you. Hare Krishna.